Hey everybody, Guru Jerry Valido here with Cinco Estilos Urban Arnis. Thank you again for watching another installment of 5 Minutes with Cinco Estilos. In the last episode, we talked about larga mano, long hand, long range. Okay, and I talked about how the distance from your opponent will kind of dictate the kind of weapon that you're going to use in larga mano. So, using the Bob bag here as an example, if I'm this far away from Bob, it's obvious I cannot reach him with my natural weapons. But with this, you know, axe handle, which is a good, it's almost 3 feet here, it's about 3 feet, I can now reach him very easily, okay? And do the damage that I need to do, okay? The length of the weapon fits the distance that I needed to fit and allows me to still fight effectively. Okay, now let's look at larga mano as a concept. Let's look at the concept of larga mano from the standpoint of what will allow me to extend the reach of my natural weapons. Okay? I can only be, or I should say, I have to be this close to hit Bob with my hand. I have to be this close, right, in order to kick Bob with my foot. All right, I have to be this close to maybe get some kind of skipping kick in. But really, outside this range, my natural weapons aren't effective, okay? Now, let's look at it from his standpoint. If Bob had arms and he had a stick in his hand, he can now reach me way out here, right? He can reach me way out here. But what if I did not have a weapon of this length? What if I did not have a weapon of this length? What if instead all I had was something like this? Well, this will now increase my range a little bit. So now I can actually fight him from a bit longer distance, from a bit longer of a range. Okay? That concept of larga mano can also be applied. So using my folder here, I would probably have to hold it to get its maximum reach. Probably have to hold it in a standard grip, okay? If you hold it in a Pakal grip, you're not gonna get, you're declining yourself a little bit of range, okay? So for purposes of working this concept of larga mano, we're gonna hold it in a standard grip. Let's say he swings that weapon at me, right? If he had arms, his arm, maybe about right to here, is his hand. Okay, he swings this at me. I'm not going to come all the way in here when he's giving me his arm. So, in order to use this concept of larga mano now, I'm going to aim for his arm. I'm going to aim for the thing that he's giving me. Okay? And a very simple step to the outside, allowing the weapon to pass, and I cut his arm. And then I can enter. Okay, same thing here, right? Let's say he has a backhand strike that he's giving me, okay? He's giving me a backhand strike. Well, I can duck that backhand strike and now cut him here, all right? But see the reach that I'm allowed to have as opposed to this? It's not much, but it's enough, okay? So this concept of larga mano can be applied as a concept if you're open-minded enough to embrace it. I have now the ability to cut my opponent. If he goes to kick at me, I can cut his leg. All right? He has a baseball bat, but he tries to go to kick at me, okay? And then I enter. So, kind of play with that and understand that larga mano is a bit of a larger umbrella than some people give it credit for. Yes, larga mano can be used with a long weapon. Okay? Yes, larga mano can be used with a short weapon. Okay? Yes, larga mano can be used with no weapons. So try to embrace that concept, but remember the underlying factor is always distance and what they are giving you. If he is giving me just a fist and I could stop his forward momentum with a long range weapon, great. If he's giving me a stick and all I've got is this, great. If he's giving me a long weapon and now I have a long weapon, great. You just need to know how to use Lagomano. Take that, play with it, see what you come up with. Thank you for listening. Stay safe, and we'll see you on the next one.